Three is a magic number. Yes, it is. It's a magic number. Somewhere in the ancient mystic trinity, you get three as a magic number.
Three.
3, 6, 9.
12.
12, 15, 18.
21.
21, 24, 27. 30.
Now multiply from 10 backwards.
3 times 10 is 30.
Going
3 times 6 is 18. 3 times 5 is 3.
Yeah,
that's a magic number.
A man and a woman had a little man. Yes, they did.
That's a magic number.
Sick of your boss, need to take revenge. I love this ad. In the front, it feels like a very good little, what is it, partner thing to go with that massacre at the last place.
Yep. I'm a 35 years old hygiene technician. Karst, are you in the game now?
I'm in the game now.
Okay, I'm going to read the briefing.
She's over here in the corner.
I'm 22.
I'm 35.
I'm going to sing the doom song.
As they are an important benefactor, it is imperative that you sanitize and restore this Omnicorp facility with due haste and diligence. Officials are waiting anxiously for your work to be complete so as to return the facility to full operational status. A repeat of the fault occurring in the AI subroutines seems highly unlikely, so do not be alarmed by the non-organic entities still stationed here. Work fast, work far, work hard, work completely, work discreetly. Leanne. All right. Time to clean up, guys. There's one collectible here, it's in the bathroom, and I'll get it when we get to it. So,
Oh my gosh, it is glitching a lot today.
It is, holy shit.
Goodness.
I'm not seeing anything yet, but...
Because you're the host.
Yeah, I know, I still sometimes see it, I guess we'll see what happens.
So, this is a big level, though, this is the biggest level we've ever done. I kind of wish Shuby was here, but he's taking a nap.
Aww.
Yeah, I mean, he said he would join us, but... And you killed me already. Wonderful.
I did?
You sure did.
Sorry. I didn't need to get hit over the head for it, thanks.
Oh god,
I don't...
How
do we get out of this room? We're trapped!
My body's still here.
We can walk through the laser bar, but...
Is my body still here to anybody else?
Huh.
No, but that's how it usually goes.
Alright,
let's get some buckets up in this bitch.
Yes, it's in the next room.
At least they're close by.
Listen, the blue barriers are important because there are defense turrets on the ceiling. Dang it. That are like busted out right now. They're not working, which is good. We need to replace them, but that needs to be the last thing we do. Because if we replace them now, they're going to shoot at us if we walk through the blue barrier with an item, like the laser gun. Or...
And presumably that's going to cause more bullet holes, isn't it?
It's going to cause more bullet holes, casings, and blood spatter.
Yep, definitely for last. I cannot get enough of this Golden Eagle mech. I want it.
You mean the Falcon
3? I want
3.
It in Mech Warrior. I want this in Mech Warrior 5 Mercenaries. Please put it in.
It's not a mech, it's a robot.
You're a robot.
It's not a robot suit, it's power armor.
All you need to do is upscale it, and it'll solve that problem.
It's a space station.
It's a robot.
It's a what?
It's a robot.
I thought we were talking about the place for a second there. I'm like, the place isn't a robot, or we're in trouble.
Oh, no, the place is a station. You're right. Yeah, it's a space station. These bits of robot are very heavy. So, I mean, I guess they're not really, really heavy. The Domestobots are, though. We have to get rid of the Domestobots, and they're pretty heavy.
These guys feel like a iRobot reference a little bit. More than a Terminator thing. These guys, specifically, the one in the Mold Light right now.
Yeah, that's a Domestobot.
Where is Incinerator?
They look different.
The what now, Karst?
The Incinerator.
Oh, it's through here, up these stairs.
For all of my incinerating pleasures.
Indeed, yes.
Which is probably the first thing I'll do is clear a path to it for you then.
Yeah, it's up the stairs to the hallway and straight ahead of the hallway.
Upstairs.
Okay. Yeah. These stairs there.
Okay.
What?
Bullshit these optic
warriors. Hold on, I gotta bring my dirty bucket. I gotta incinerate this water.
Okay. Well, put like bullet casings in it or something.
Okay.
It's up the stairs to the hallway and
Well, hold on, I gotta put bullet casings in it.
I'll mop up the blood, clear you away to the incinerator.
Well, just like,
thank you.
What
such
I do,
a gentleman.
What I do with the dirty buckets is that I put stuff in them, like
the
casings.
Dirty bubble.
The dirty bubble.
He's
take the dirty bubble challenge.
He's griffining again. Get him CCs of stat.
He's what
get
now?
Him CCs of stat.
I don't know. I tried to come up with something medical again. He's griffining, Peter griffining.
Oh no, I was not Peter griffining. No, no, no. I was dirty bubbling.
He was dirty bubbling.
I don't think Nick watched SpongeBob like we did.
Oh, no. Is Nick actually intelligent? Nick, are you actually
to
intelligent?
An extent.
I never got it. I do like the whole I need it joke. I quote that a lot. I don't need it.
Golly, that's an old
one.
I need it! That's like the second
episode.
Like that.
Yeah, I know, right?
I know barely anything else about the rest of the show.
Oh, it's okay. We forgive you.
Oh, well, you do.
A little bit. Not a lot.
I want this brew. Not really.
I hate how big this fucking level is.
It's enormous.
Bullshit!
And there's like an entire section, sections we haven't even touched, so.
Ugh!
And this, I want to have a photo with it. This, my friends, is called the Summoner. It's a mech from Mech Warrior. Who are you trying to kid?
You mean Sprite M.
Oh, I won't hear it! It's even got the same frigging head!
Does it really? Wow.
Yes! Like, the Summoner's... Well, the Summoner's got, like, a head off to the side, but it's always looked like it has a head... like, a missile rack for a head, because it's right in the dead center. How do we fix these, by the way? Do they have to be welded out, I'm guessing?
What, the... footprint? Yes.
These, like, indents?
Yes. Yeah, they need to be welded out.
I can't mop them off.
No, they need to be... You need the welder for that.
Alright, I'll start to take some of these bodies
in. Just right here. I found it already.
Possibly gonna get a little bit of blood, even though I'm trying my best.
Son of a bitch, I tripped over the goddamn bucket.
I was worried about doing that.
Oh, oops.
Oh, no. Oh, good.
Let me get more buckets.
That's a little worse.
What the heck just launched across the screen?
Me.
I think I turned it into a melty bit, but it launched across the screen for some reason. Oh, there's like 3 laser guns here, by the way, in this level. I don't know why.
Am I walking in blood? I'm walking in blood.
Sounds like a job for Flannery.
Oh, you splashed
it. God damn it, I keep spilling water!
At least that was a clean one.
I was gonna say this one was clean, hopefully.
Oh, watch out, there's like a puddle of muck up here. Oh, okay, alright, let's do it. Let's not do it.
Oh, that's what a melted robot looks like, is it?
Yeah.
Or is that just fun?
Probably so.
What the heck? I just washed this. You guys still there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Yeah.
Sorry, I'm just lasering
the sound
stuff away.
The sound of silence.
It's a big level, we gotta concentrate.
I'm putting like a million bullet shells into a fucking bucket. This is what I'm doing with my life.
Well, be careful because the bullets have a really, really weird hitbox.
Oh, I know.
Now we're entering
the
whole depression stage.
With all these bullets.
We're hitting the depression stage of this game of like, why are we doing this?
Exactly, just like, I have a degree, why do I...
Fine, we don't have to play this.
Why
Fine.
Is the bucket empty?
Who cares about
this? This is a sad, sad statement to be garnered from all that.
Oh, nope, that's not what I want. Okay, I guess I grabbed the thing I didn't want to grab. Okay, that's super cool. Thanks, Dan.
Okay, you know what? I'm going to try speedrunning this.
No.
I mean, I'll take my time. I mean, I'll be careful not to break anything, but I'm just going to, out of pure curiosity, see what I can do here. Hey, not counting things getting stuck in the walls with physics.
Oh, just be careful. There's fucking blood and everything everywhere.
I think I got most of the blood. No. Most of it in our present course.
Okay.
I'm not gonna be walking it back and forth for the time being.
There's an entire half of this stage you haven't even seen yet.
Yeah, how's this? Hey, what you doing to my bucket? Oh, you're doing it to them.
Yeah, they take a little minute to go away fully. This is the barrel area, by the way. There's lots of boxes in it for some reason. Oh, is that the Bob note? I think that's the Bob note. Hold on. Yes! Awesome. Alright, nobody touch me. I'm going to the trunk. And now I just need to get the collectible for this level, and we'll be good.
Ah! This is going to be a fun one to see the footage back on later, you know, assuming it doesn't vanish off the face of the earth again.
Well, that's all that. But
because you're going to, like, put it into fast motion and it's going to be supersonic.
I want to put it into fast motion. I have no need to do that just yet. Do you have a clean bucket anywhere?
I think this one's clean, but can't guarantee it.
Yep. I need to clean this hallway over here.
I'm guessing you're on laser duty again.
Well, there's three laser guns here, so if y'all want to do any lasering...
I might help out with that in a minute, yes.
There's a lot of things I need lasering, and I mean a lot.
Alright. Yep, I'll take that for a bit then.
There's regular bullet holes. Remember to fire it for so long it can overheat.
Oh, I thought you just meant it would. Oh, I get ya. Well, maybe I don't know how this is gonna work, but did you see me trying this the other day?
Yeah, that doesn't help very much.
That's still gonna cause it to overload. Okay.
Yeah, I mean, much slower, but yeah. Carson's back. Hello.
I'm back.
The crates are. Where are you going? Don't throw that away.
What?
That's a crate.
I can see how it's overloading now.
Oh.
I think I can manage that.
That's not the crate area. That's a barrel area.
Are there a bunch of crates? Oh my god. Oh my god.
I know, they spawned a bunch of crates in there to fool you. The crate area is in the adjacent room. It's over here. There's two crate areas, actually. I like to save one for cardboard boxes and one for regular crates. Yeah, there's one on one side of the room, over there, and one on the other side. So, yep. Oh, thanks.
Okay, question about the laser gun overheating. Once it starts overheating, does the time go down a little bit? Because that thing feels like it's overheating really fast now.
It doesn't... What do you mean, does the time go down?
Like the time in between it charging back up again.
No, it's the same. It remains the same.
Alright. It felt like it was getting faster to me.
I'm ready.
And this whole time I've been speedrunning, I did not realize I had always run on. I don't remember leaving that on. I thought I turned that off after last time.
Turned it off in part two.
I did, but I turned it back on a couple of episodes back for to like experiment with something, and I thought I turned it back on again afterwards. I guess not. It's alright. I didn't kill you, did I?
No. The USB receptacle, the punch-o-matic, is over here where I am, if y'all want to turn in USBs. Nobody's looking.
I don't have any. Where is it? There you are. Oh, okay. There it is. Punch-o-matic. Okay.
Where's the bu- Oh, when I said bucket earlier, I meant where's the, like, bucket machine to put everything in the buckets?
Downstairs. Or,
Oh, you mean the bucket? The bin machine.
For the biohazard bins, it's in here. I don't know where you are, though.
It's in the display room.
How do I put a USB drive in? Do I just touch it automatic?
Yeah, just touch it. Doesn't do it automatically, just force it to. Like,
yeah,
ram it in.
Okay, I'm
fit about the size of this level, good god.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty so fucking far. Ass.
I like it though, it's my favorite level.
We are here to kick names and take ass.
Oh man, my favorite. I mean, what?
What?
Sorry?
What?
So I had a couple specific ideas for Halloween. Like, I have a one that I'm saving for Halloween of somebody, like, in the forest using, like, a ritual, like, summoning circle.
Oh, that sounds cool.
Yeah, and then I have one of, like, a ghost floating above a river, because in New Mexico, we have a one of our more popular folklore, like, you know, like, urban legends is La Llorona, which is, like, a woman that, like, haunts rivers because she drowned her children.
Is that... Oh, never mind. I was gonna say that sounds like the blue lady out of Avatar, but that's a lot less benevolent.
Yeah.
Yeah, no. It's an evil thing. But yeah, so I'm gonna do that, and then... what else?
That might be the first supernatural thing I've heard of from, like, New Mexico. I usually follow the aliens because it's, like, an alien hotspot.
Yeah.
Roswell.
And then,
not even that. Phoenix. Phoenix
Chupacabra.
That's Arizona, though.
Yeah.
Well, it's sort of like on the... It's right.
And then
the
I'm gonna do a Dia de los Muertos one because in New Mexico we have that every year. And then... I don't know, I have a couple. I can show you.
Well, there it goes.
You've now got me thinking of something, like, almost always the artwork of the Chupacabra is terrifying. It's, like, hideous. You should cute it up.
Yeah.
What is a Chupacabra?
It's like a monster
we'll call
that eats Chuppy.
Goats. Oh, that doesn't sound so
I'm
nice.
I'm actually really surprised you haven't heard of that one, because
yeah,
that's, like, one of the most famous.
Yeah, like, ever. Honestly, not even just in New Mexico.
This isn't very culturally aware of things.
No, well, the thing is, there's kind of two. There's one that's an urban legend, and there's also the possibility that it's a real kind of animal. But they're still debating whether they've actually found one or whether it's just a coyote or something.
Oh, yeah.
It kind of looks
like
a hairless dog. A little bit. They look like a hairless dog, most likely, but they've been blown out of proportion, and there's a possibility.
Yeah,
they look
and
like
honestly,
giant
in Mexico,
and spikes coming out of its back.
Whoa,
in Mexico, there is a very there is a fucking breed of hairless dog.
Yeah,
so.
The Zolo Xquintili or something like that. Somebody's messaging.
Is it CB?
Is it you? Were you sending pictures?
No, I'm gonna wait until after I'm done with this before I do anything like that.
Oh,
need
I don't...
more buckets.
I hope it's CB.
I get the bucket, I'm gonna throw up. I didn't get it, so I think it's just you.
Oh, might be Sophix then.
Wait, ooh, what's this?
What's this?
Only game I've played
oh, whoa.
Space Station 13 and Janitor's World.
Oh, whoa.
Oh, whoa. Not that kind of oh, whoa. You can't repeat that on the stream.
Sure you can.
I love doing that to people who accidentally say, oh, whoa.
I love doing it to... I love just saying, oh, mo, and blowing people's perspectives. Expectations, sorry, I meant.
Hey, Karis, I want to show you something really cool. Come here. Come. I'm
okay,
right
hold
here.
Hold on, let me finish the splatter. I'm anal.
Okay, that's fine. I am too.
Okie dokie.
Watch this. This is the bathroom, okay? Watch this.
Oh, God, the bathroom.
Look. Oh, it's a toilet. Oh, what is it full of? What? It's full. Hold on.
I'm not gonna touch the water. I'm gonna leave that all up to you.
You can rinse your mop off in the toilets.
Oh, you can like
whoa,
infinitely.
Whoa.
No, they'll get dirty. But like, there's six
damn.
Toilets here.
No.
Unfortunately, they do not flush. The House of Horror has toilets that flush though, and you can do it infinitely there.
Ah. Oh. That's so cool.
There we go. Hey.
I just had a catastrophic physics disaster.
Uh-oh. Hey, Karsh.
Yes?
Red pill or blue pill?
Blue.
Look.
What do you have?
It's a collectible.
Aha! Matrix!
There you are. Look, red pill or blue pill?
I don't remember which was which.
I don't either.
I don't either, fuck. And I only... I mean, there's a 50% chance of being right.
And I mean, you don't lose much if you pick the wrong one, so...
Yeah, exactly.
Once again, I'm picturing Surgeon Simulator where I'll just go high for a little while.
Oh god, Surgeon Simulator is a treasure. A national treasure. Where's my dog?
I keep
oh, I left him outside.
Bringing it up in comparison to this game for obvious reasons, and I will continue to.
You left him outside?
I was so concerned. Yeah, he's outside.
Is he okay out there?
Yeah, we have an enclosed yard, and it's okay. Pretty small, so he doesn't really... He just kind of likes to sniff around.
Well, make sure he doesn't, find an ant bed or something.
A what?
An ant bed.
Oh, no, he's good.
One time I had to look after a dog that was a Tenterfield Terrier, if you know what that was.
No.
Yeah.
It's the size of a guinea pig.
Oh my god, that's so tiny.
It was such a tiny dog, and it was absolutely beautiful, but you couldn't ever have it outside without keeping an eye on it. It would get through the gate in seconds. It was just so small.
Oh, he wants to come in. Let him in. Oh, great.
I even had to be careful when I'm sleeping, like if it got in my bed or something for obvious reasons, to keep an eye on it.
Oh god, he might squish it.
There's an actual Terminator in here.
Yeah, we have to put him in the trash or incinerator.
Aww.
He's really heavy, though. He's really heavy, so melt him down first.
Okay.
Him and all the dead Mastobots are really heavy.
No. We have to put him in the incinerator slowly and then put his hand in.
Yeah, so that he gives a thumbs up.
Okay, I brought you some water for this section. So I think we're going to need it.
So what I was saying, Karst, was when we get around to House of Horror,
yes.
Because I want it to be all of us, all five of us, I want it to be like it'll be all five of us there, so we'll have a full house. Ha 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 ha. So I want to do my intro for that one, I want to make like a full house type intro style, like credit sequence.
Yeah.
So, it's going to involve me trying
to
find...
And I was just saying, I wish I could animate, because I would do that. Totally do that.
Yeah.
I need to find out how to eliminate the character HUD, like the hands and stuff, from in front of the screen. So I can, have good camera shots of all of our characters.
Well, here's the question, what if you can't? Question that has plagued me for eternity with some games.
I know in this game you can, because remember the first couple of videos we did? And we went back to your office, and I was invisible flying around, so there's gotta be a way to do it.
Oh yeah, I didn't think about that. Well, the question is, can we activate it at will, hopefully.
We will see. We have to figure that one out.
I tried to, make a several different machinimas a while back, but the problem with HUDs was always getting in the way.
How the hell is the fucking hallway on fire when all I did was pick up a box?
That's my bad, sorry. The bullet holes don't want to, cooperate, and they decided they wanted to put flames all over the walls instead. So that's my bad.
No, that's fine, I was just glitching a lot, and then all of a sudden everything was on fire, and I was like, how did I manage to do this?
Story of my life. I was glitching and then everything was on fire. How did I do this?
Yeah, like, how has everything gone this wrong?
And there's the briefcase. I hope that there's nothing important in that.
No, we're supposed to destroy the briefcases, so you're good. There's only one level where there's an important thing in a briefcase, and that is a Shadow Warrior level. And there's money in
it. I'm sure makes total context.
Well, there's money in it. The collectibles of Shadow Warrior is just a bunch of money. 22 stacks of money. If you collect them all, you get an achievement.
Where's the boombox in this level?
Oh shit, Stevie's gonna be so mad. I don't know.
I saw it downstairs somewhere.
Oh yeah, it's probably in the office area, the big area. Whoa. Possessed Bucket of Doom. Alright, okay. You just hang out there, Bucket, alright? Just hang out there. That was freaky deaky.
You know, earlier when I was mentioning Jack and Daxter and how I couldn't get that working because it was still possessed?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know if I've ever mentioned the glitches that happen on that or if this is the first time, but basically every character's eyes disappear.
Oh, wow.
Black, soulless eyes. It's horrifying.
You did not mention that, no. That sounds terrifying.
And I thought I had fixed it, but no, like, the deeper you get in, the glitches start coming back, and I just, like, I'm sorry, this was more horrifying than any other game, intentional horror game I could have played tonight.
I wish my copy of Jack and Daxter had done that.
Just download the emulator and go to town. You don't even have to try, you'll just get it by accident.
I wonder why it's such a bad emulation.
I haven't got a clue. But what I'm really pissed off is that the emulating website said it's working 100% now. Bullshit it is!
That's a false advertisement.
They lied.
Gotta work out one or two possessions.
Making like a little
jingle. By the way, more on these mechs. This looks a little like a Stormcrow. Maybe a Nova, it's hard to say. It's too narrow.
Oh, there's the radio, I found it. It's in the office area.
And that's, it's kind of like someone mixed a Timberwolf with an Atlas. I like it.
These are all likely references to, you know, mech games, you know. It wouldn't surprise me.
Well, I could believe they could just make it by accident, but some of these do look really, really intentional. We have to close these toilet doors before we go, don't we? Or we'll start some kind of giant disaster.
No, because like they flop around as you enter and exit. They can't really close or open with any amount of reliability.
Oh my god.
What?
Someone in my chat just asked, why is there blood on the toilet? Someone answered Taco Bell.
Oh god. Taco Bell's not that bad.
Who said those things because I want to give them commendations.
Ashari answered Taco Bell.
Don't know who that is, but give them my commendations.
You should start reading their stuff. They're awesome. I mean, not appropriate for this show, but just trust me. Like what you'd like what they work on.
I might. I don't know. I don't like to read. Lazy.
You write? You write really well. I'm gonna keep playing that up.
I write, doesn't mean I like to read.
But you gotta read your stuff, don't you?
I proofread it, but that's not the same. It's like editing a video, alright? I still have to watch what we do, but I don't have to watch other people do it.
What?
Does that make sense?
No.
It depends on whether you're saying we have to watch them make the video or we have to watch their video.
Their video. It's like it's the difference between making like one and watching somebody else's creation. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, that's exactly why I don't think any of you'll ever check my stuff out, because I was very, very cringy back on the Twitch days.
Oh, I was too. I mean, not in the Twitch. I wasn't ever on Twitch. Just for about freaking the fuck out. But my early YouTube videos are extremely cringy if they aren't already today.
Mine are as well.
Do you know how I did it? For some of my early Let's Play stuff and Machinima stuff, I had to run it through a VCR recorder.
Holy crap.
A VCR DVD recorder and like burn them to multiple sources. It was ridiculous.
Is this robot glitching out for everybody else or just me?
Hang on, I'm coming.
Carson is right here. Do you see this robot?
I see you whacking a poor defenseless robot, but I don't see the horrors that's probably going on your screen.
Is it glitched through the floor? Whoa.
No, I'm holding.
You are like God.
The circle of life.
Destroy it. Destroy it now.
Okay.
You might, well, I might need to melt it because it gets
pretty heavy. I did not murder him!
What is that from?
iRobot again.
Oh, right.
I don't know how many people saw that movie. It was insanely popular over here, but I never got it.
It wasn't popular over here. In fact, it was criticized, but I liked it. Nick, do you know Cotton Eye Joe? The song Cotton Eye Joe?
Oh, yes. I used to have it, an MP3 of it.
Why?
I was a,
because
sort
he's
of like
trying
the
to figure
UNDYT.
Out where did he come from? Where did he go? Where did he
it was
come
sort
from,
of similar to
Joe?
The YTMND thing you mentioned earlier. I would like hear songs in videos and I'd track them down and I think I'm probably going to use them for something.
I love Men at Work. They have that good song with the saxophone in it. Who can it be now? Who can it be now? Exactly, yeah.
As a saxophone fan, as someone who wanted to play it a lot in school, it's gonna take a lot to beat K. Rool. I don't like
now?
That frigging solo is gonna take mountains to topple.
There's a lot of smooth jazz you haven't heard, my friend.
Oh my no, dog. I probably still haven't heard it, and I'm like that remix of that was just golden.
My dog is so sad because the cat is sitting on the windowsill and he wants so badly for her to play with him. And she's not going to play with him, but she's never played with him, so I don't know why he keeps expecting her to.
This was the golden retriever again, yeah?
Yes, Conan.
That explains it to me, because my lab's the same. She wants to, like, have the cat as a chew toy, pretty much.
Oh, no, he doesn't want to hurt her or anything. He just wants to play.
No, same. Same. My dog just wants to play with it and just use it as, like, an animatronic toy, pretty much.
Yeah. Just like, let's play. Like, you can chase me. He loves when people chase him. That's his favorite thing. So, like, if we really want to, like, wear him out and, like, energy out, like, we have to chase him around because he'll pick up a toy when he wants us to chase him, and so we have to chase him around and act like we're gonna steal the toy so that he can run from us.
Oh, my dog does that too. She's like 6 years old.
Yeah, it's adorable.
Mine is very specific and very lucky, unbelievably lucky, because she grew up with a cattle dog that apparently chased her around and wore her out of a date, and I've got a little border collie who I feel like has filled that role.
Hi, Conan. Why are you so wiggly?
He wants to play.
I had the mask.
Yeah, he brought me
toys.
His ball. It's like, baby, that's not the throwing ball. That's the I put food in it and watch you struggle to get it out ball.
Oh, he just sees it as a toy.
Oh, you've got him a Kong toy.
Yeah.
Those are pretty good.
Love those.
Yeah, he has one that we put peanut butter in, and then he has a ball that, like, has a hole in it that he rolls around with his nose. I'll have to take a video or something because he loves that thing. And he brought it to me, and it's like, baby, you had breakfast like 3 hours ago. I'm not gonna put food in it just yet, okay? Hey, you're so wiggly. You're so wiggly. Why are you so wiggly? He's constantly wiggling. He's a very wiggly boy.
Does he wiggle his butt?
He does. He does like a little dance sometimes, like when he's like really excited to see someone, and it's like, dear God, you used to be a wolf.
I used to have a friend that they owned a coon hound. It was her name was Twain, and she was tall.
Yeah.
And she had a strong tail, and I don't say that like lightly. Whenever she would wiggle her tail, she would get so excited that if you were next to her, you would end up with a rash on your leg.
Oh my gosh!
If you were hit with her tail, it was like a whip.
Yeah, because coonhound fur is really rough, too.
It was.
I used to have a coonhound, and her bark was so funny.
She loved me for some reason. Whenever I went to their house, I would sit on their couch, and it was like a torpedo coming out of nowhere. Just right into my stomach.
Yeah.
Those are the friends I would go to the bar with and do trivia.
I like trivia. I just suck at it.
It was really fun when I was doing it, especially since the trivia guy became our friend, and so he would like give us answers that we didn't know.
Cheating.
And because of that, we got accepted at the trivia tournament in downtown Atlanta. as one of the team contestants. And so he's like, oh man.
How did that go?
Sad?
There's only 8 teams invited. The top... Squeaky, squeaky. The top 8 teams of around Metro Atlanta were invited. And we were like number 8, and we came in 8th place.
Squeaky! I'm sorry.
I hope I don't crash the computer now.
She's not hanging back.
She's really not. She loves that thing, doesn't she? Oh, this will be a fun part to edit.
I'm so sorry.
You need to get a video of this and then send it to me so I can put it in the
yes.
video.
Yes. No, you seriously need to, like, your phone, surely. You need to get something of this.
Hold on, hold on. When he starts again, I'll take a video. One of his toys, I think, because he obliterated his little sushi toy that I had for him, but he pulled a squeaker out. Mm-hmm. So he had the squeaker in his mouth, so he could rapid squeak it,
and
that was a dark day in this house. I thought we were all gonna go crazy. But at the same time, we're all conditioned to love the squeaking noise because it means he's not doing anything bad.
Yeah, it means he's inside the house and
yeah, exactly. Look at the camera.
This needs to be the...
Look. Focus.
You're taking out advice. I was gonna say, this needs to be the highlight of this video when we get to this episode, is you just...
Oh boy.
The dead silence, the squeaker in the background.
Yeah.
And all of us trying to keep a straight face.
Right?
And then there was nothing.
Yeah, he found some. What are you doing? Why are you wiggling? He's coming up to me like, hi, I'm here.
I'm on camera now.
You're gonna be a celebrity.
Well, I mean, I'm not.
I wish you could see his cute little bow tie in that video.
He has on a bow tie?
He does. I think you can see it in one of the Discord pictures I showed when, like, I got him some whipped cream. And he has his vest on.
Oh, he's got a bow tie in that one?
Yeah, it's on his collar.
Oh, that's adorable.
Yeah, it is amazing, because I wanted to get him a Halloween collar when everything came out, because, you know, Halloween's my jam. So I did, and all of the Halloween collars had, like, a little bow on them, and I was like, you know what? Fuck it, I'm doing it.
Ooh, this dude's arm is just kind of freaking out. All right. I like how this place is called Omnicorp. It's like Megacorp, but not. Any other bodies in here? I just saw the two.
I think that's all of them. Still annoying we can't have big buckets. Like stuff that can fit those giant melted body parts in them.
Oh yeah, I know.
I can always only fit like one at a time and then it's all gone.
Well, the Santa level has like big baskets that can fit them, but at the same time they're not programmed to be something you can hold stuff in. So when you hit the left click button to set them upright, they fling up and anything inside them goes everywhere. Like they snap to attention as opposed to the actual bins and the buckets here, which kind of slowly set themselves. So they don't spill their contents.
A lot of data logs here.
Yes, there are. I haven't been reading them, though. So.
Yeah, we scanned in, like, at least 10.
Oh, wait, are we supposed to put the data logs in the Punch-O-Matic? I wonder. I've never done it. I've always just tried
them. Oh, God. That's not going to be fun to find out that's the case.
Well, I've just always destroyed them. Again, it doesn't matter.
Once again, it's another matter of why. Why are we being asked to do this?
Because we are space janitors, not just regular janitors. We got laser guns and floaty crowny things.
Okay, obviously that, though.
Okay,
why are you burning up the chairs?
Are we not supposed to?
I wasn't.
You don't have to, but...
Oh, okay.
I'm burning up the mech.
Anyway. What the fuck was I gonna say?
I don't know.
Oh, right! Nobody hates furries more than furries.
True. True that.
Like, whenever I hear somebody go, like, fucking furries, it's usually a furry. Nobody hates furries more than furries.
Or my mom.
Or your mom.
You want to know what's heartbreaking?
Well, I guess that confirms Linkara's one.
The most heartbreaking thing that you could ever see in your life when it comes to dogs is my dog when she had a favorite toy, right? It was a, what do they call him? Pillow Pets. It was a really small one, though.
I think I know where this is going.
It was a hippo? I think it was a hippo. It was like a purple hippo pillow pet. She loved that thing, and... We got it for her when she was really little, before her adult teeth came in. Well, then her adult teeth came in, and she began to tear it up because that's how she used to play with it, only now it's being destroyed.
Yep.
And it started to lose all its flow. She was tearing the eyes off of it, but she still loved it. Like, it was her most favoriteest toy in the world. In fact, that toy is how we found out she was teething, because she would get blood on it because her adult teeth are falling out.
Ouch.
Well, we decided that she had torn up too much of it, and my mom was going to fix it and put it on display in her house in her guest room or something. But she never got around to it. It just stayed on top of the dryer in our house, and mine and my dad's house. Well, it just stayed there, and it stayed there, and Gracie never knew it was there because it was out of her sight. I guess it was the entire house smelled like her, so she didn't know it was there. And then earlier this year, we moved, and mom grabbed that toy, and she goes, oh, how long has this been here? And I said, ever since you put it there years ago. And she goes, go, just throw it out, it's gross.
Aww.
And she threw it in the trash can, and closed the lid on the trash can. But the moment she closed that lid on the trash can, Gracie comes running to the kitchen, and she starts whining, and we're like, what's wrong, baby? And she goes over to the trash can, stands up on her hind legs, and, like, puts her front paws against the trash can, looks up at us like, And, like, she knew
all
her toy was
in there. All around me are familiar faces.
And I'm like, oh, mama, no. Don't make me do this.
Oh, baby.
It was so heartbreaking.
At that point, I would have gotten it out. I wouldn't have hesitated.
If my mom was there, I would have 100%.
Conan started teething this week. I found blood on one of his chew toys. And he started chewing, you know, he's chewing a lot more often.
Yeah.
And he tore apart two of his toys, so we're gonna let him have the hard toys for now. But the one that he has, a little dragon toy, if you hear him squeaking, it's usually that.
Yeah.
It's weird. It's like a really loose material with like sort of like little pockets in it, so that if he stretches if he tears the fabric, like it'll stretch before it'll tear.
Yeah.
And it's not stuffed, so
so he doesn't have to rip out stuffing.
Yeah, it's really good. So I need to like get online and order him a couple more, just in case it ever gets discontinued, so that I still have one for him.
We have one for Gracie that is really good, actually. She loves that thing because it doesn't squeak. It's not a loud squeaker, but it does make noise. It makes crinkle noises, and it has no fluff in it. She loves that thing.
Yeah, he has a crinkly octopus. Like the tentacles are crinkly, and the head squeaks. But I think his favorite, it seems, is the dragon. So I need to definitely stock up on those just in case. I need to stock up on a couple of things the next time I have money, actually.
Oh, there goes the bucket.
I can't believe it's taken me this long to ask you about this, but the job...
Let's see. Today's Thursday. So Tuesday, I got an order on my table for what I believe to be 30 donuts, because the person who wrote down the order does not know anything beyond her position in the bakery, which is cake decorator. So if she needs to write down an order for donuts or for bread or, you know, whatever, she'll just write down exactly what the customer says, doesn't ask them about it, doesn't say, oh, maybe you mean this or this. No, she just writes it down as they say and just leaves it at that, gives it to the person, you know? And that's irritating because she wrote down 10 chocolate covered donuts with sprinkles, big. 10 white icing donuts with sprinkles, big. 10 white icing donuts with sprinkles, small. And I'm like, big, small? Is this, what does this mean? Like a big box? Like a dozen? Small.
Yeah, or are they talking about like munchkins?
Well, like we only have one size of donut. I knew she wasn't talking about the size of the donut itself, but I thought she was talking about box sizes. Does big mean our large boxes, our dozen sizes? Or does small mean our half dozen sizes? That's what I thought it meant at first, because it was never specified. And so I got real mad about it and posted on Twitter how, of course, the week before my very first vacation ever, I have to do 30 dozen donuts. And I wasn't very pleased about that.
Mm-hmm.
Wednesday morning comes around, and the order has been modified a little bit. My boss came in, saw it, and made it a little easier to comprehend. The big and the small was referring to the size of the sprinkles.
What?
Yeah, we have...
Oh my god.
How are you supposed to fucking guess that?
Exactly. You know, we have many different types of sprinkles, but we don't refer to them as big and small.
The next time you see her, I want you to do a trick in honor of my grandfather.
Okay.
I want you to say to her, do you guys want lollies? Right? And if she says yes, go up to her, hand her a bag of sprinkles, and say, you can only take the one.
Am I missing a joke there, or what?
Think about it.
Lollies as in lollipops, right?
Yes, obviously. Like, trick her into that.
Yeah.
I guess the punchline wasn't as fun as I thought it was.
So I'm stupid. I don't realize things sometimes. Grab it. Oh no. No. Not again. I think I lost connection, guys. Again. Time to see what I can before I lose connection. There it goes. Aww. Son of a bitch.
Hello.
Hey. That was internet. That was
please
internet.
Please tell us.
Don't worry. That was internet.
I was gonna say, please tell us that wasn't what we thought it was.
No. It was internet. It was not the computer crashing. We're good. So when we left off, you told me about the lolly joke, and I said that
yeah,
I think that went over my
head.
I said I think I that went a little over my head. And then you said...
Yeah, Cast has got it since then, but it hasn't made it any funnier. I feel like the Joker sometimes.
Well, I still don't understand it because I'm a loser.
Okay, the joke is sprinkles.
Yes.
Do you get sprinkles in bags over there, right?
Sure, yeah.
Where you like have to like buy them in
the
shop.
You get a lot of them at once.
Yeah.
Yeah, so imagine the absurdity for a second of handing her a bag of sprinkles and saying you can only take one.
Oh, yeah.
And now it clicks.
Why'd you close the incinerator door?
I didn't. Did I?
No, it sorry, I guess that was the internet thing. It opened by itself. But anyway,
I thought that would...
You could
probably modify it into something like, take a big one. That would be an even funnier way.
Take your most favorite. Yeah.
Oh no.
I hear it.
I got it. I caught it before it fell.
Well, but basically, I actually never got to finish that story. In the end, the lady wanted 10 donuts each, chocolate covered with big sprinkles, with small sprinkles, so on and so forth. But that would have been fine, but we don't pack them in packs of 10. We pack them in packs of 12. We do dozen packs. Dozen packs. That's the biggest we do. The smallest we do is 6. There's no in between. So this lady wanted 10.
Yeah, nobody does it in other numbers than 6 and 12.
Sometimes 13, baker's dozen, but...
good point.
But at the same time, nobody does 10. Who does 10? I've never heard of that before.
I've never heard of it either.
But that lady, she wanted 10, which would have driven her price up, like, what's the word? A lot. I was trying to make up a word for a lot, but I couldn't think of it.
Extranormously or something like that.
Sure, why not? That sounds legit. It would have driven the price up by a good large bit.
Mm-hmm.
So I went ahead and did the 3 12 packs, right? That takes down the price quite a good bit because buying a 12 pack of donuts versus like you could get the price of a box of a dozen versus paying for 10 individual donuts.
Yeah.
Right? That makes sense. So I packed them up as 12. You get more donuts for less the price. That's the point I'm trying to drive home here. Well, I come
in... Yep, this thing, didn't they?
I come in today. They picked it up. They were supposed to pick it up at 12. But I come in today, and I noticed that my donut case is full of donuts because the evening shift person didn't bother doing half of their job last night, which made me really mad, but that's another story. However, a good chunk of them donuts were awfully familiar. The person never came in to pick them up, so that made me mad.
That's annoying.
Yep. After going through all that trouble, they ended up not picking them up.
I don't understand. Did they pay for it?
No, you pay for them when you pick them up.
That's kind of dumb.
Yeah, I know. It's super dumb because people do that with cake orders all the time. And it's,
yeah, and then it's you completely... make it, they, you know, you do the labor, and then they don't pay, so...
Which is why my coworkers are started to say stuff like, we gotta make them pay a deposit, you know?
Yeah.
But the boss is like, no, Ingles can't afford that. And I'm like, oh my god, I fucking hate Ingles. I hate Ingles, I hate this stupid fucking company. I hate it.
I don't blame you.
Our store manager's a fucking moron.
He's not watching this video.
Oh my god.
No.
He's gonna stumble onto my YouTube account and say, oh my god, you're that stupid furry who does YouTube videos with like 2 views per video. I'm gonna fire you now. Okay, goodbye.
Rip.
I need to give you a better... Oh, I did miss a vending machine. I forgot about the one in this room.
Oh, the med kit? Yeah.
Yeah, you take the...
The USB.
You take that, I'll take all the rubbish.
Rubbish? What's that?
You take the USBs, and I'll take this. I thought I was balancing it perfectly for a second there.
I love the crate stacking over here, it's real nice and organized.
Wait, is it where I think it is?
It's, I think Karst did it.
The one in the robot room is like a modern work of art.
Yeah, there's 2 in the robot room, but yeah, the only one that's being used is like a modern piece of art, isn't it? It's very abstract. I usually do one of the crate spaces with cardboard boxes and one of them with all the other grades.
Do we have to burn the caution wet floor signs?
No, those go in the crates in the crate area, but you don't have to put them there. You just leave them where they are.
That's everything, I think.
When we do evil science, that'll be a level where it has its own sign area. So. But that's a little ways away.
I think I just found out what the elevator's for.
Elevator.
The little platform thing.
Platform thing.
Oh, is there shit on the ceiling?
J arm, the elevator of doom. Gotta call it elevator of doom, or that's all we're talking about. It's for the guns.
Boy.
It's for the turrets.
Oh, is that the last thing to do, or?
I just want to clean them off for now, but I didn't see a point to this thing until now. Now we know why it's here.
You need a jet boots.
No, I must do it legit.
Use your jet boots. Use your rocket boots. That's what they're for.
Oh, those are, I saw this earlier and I thought this was a fire alarm or something that had gone off. Now I see it's a gun.
Oh yeah, I've been taking the guns and throwing them away. I have to direct you where to put the new ones.
Oh, speaking of which, I think they had a legitimate Quake reference a minute ago.
Oh?
The vending machine gave me something about a bitumen turret along those lines.
Hear me.
What have I done? What's Kaz doing?
I don't know. What is she doing? Where are you
I'm
at?
I'm standing on the elevator of doom.
Oh no. We call it the elevator of doom for a reason. Get off of that.
It's okay. It won't make a mess of anything. It'll just rocket you somewhere.
Aww.
If not, you know, fail at life and not decide not to work.
I am the definition of fail at life.
I think people who are dead are the definition of fail at life.
That is a good point.
This is a note.
Maybe they're
note.
Just succeeding at death really well. Did you ever think about that, huh?
You're good.
Stop it with this optimism. Stop it! Stop it!
I can't stand it. The goodness, it
He's
kills
like, no,
me.
You're not a failure at life. You're just really successful at death.
You should tell that to somebody with terminal cancer.
Oh, God.
Too soon. No, I'm just kidding.
Oh, God, no. Oh,
Stefan,
shit, no.
Stefan went out.
I wasn't even thinking.
Stefan went out like a legend.
I wasn't even thinking about him. Not bad. That was a bad joke in the first place.
Yeah, that was really sad that
it's
happened.
Fine.
It was really abrupt as well. No, the joke was fine. I don't really care. I'm not sensitive to that kind of stuff, but... I was really upset to find out about him.
Oh yeah, me too. For real.
No, the last I heard he was good. What happened?
Well, it came back.
It
I remember it coming back.
It came back. He was just a lovely person.
It came back with a vengeance too. Usually cancer does. Like if it
and
goes away.
And it was
away,
pancreatic, wasn't it?
It was bile duct.
Yeah, it was. It was very unfortunate, and he was a very lovely person, so.
It did go away for a little while, and he celebrated it and everything, but.
But it came back.
As with someone I didn't really know this person, but like I used to watch them on YouTube. They had cancer as well as leukemia, and it went away, or it started receding or something, and suddenly it came back overnight with a vengeance and killed him overnight.
Total biscuit.
No, not him. I don't like him. It was Kitty 0706.
Ah, yeah. Never heard of him. I went to say YouTube Pooper, but he's not YouTube. He was an old Gary's mod.
Gmod Idiotbox. I believe he was the Gmod Idiotbox guy. If not,
was
very
he?
Similar. No, that's Dash Bullshit.
Cancer is just.
Oh, yeah, Dash, but sorry, I thought you meant the Idiots of Gary's Mod, which is another video, and I was gonna say if he was that, then that explains why that hasn't ever gotten another episode.
He was
it
really good
felt
with
right
Gary's
doing
mod,
it without him.
He was really good, really funny. I was friends with someone who was friends with him, and he was real upset about it.
God.
But anyway, let's get off this depressing topic that's making me think my ex
is a
crisis.
Life is a carnival of pain.
We've gotten on quite a few of those topics. Might as well make the circle complete and just fucking talk about politics or something. Not actually, though.
No.
Nobody start.
No.
Captain Corp
no,
for president.
No, because there's just one punchline left to make about that, and that's politics. Is that still going on?
Unfortunately.
Oh, by the way. I didn't see the other
one. I'm tired. I want a nap. I was up until like 1 in the morning and I woke up at 7. Which is still 6 hours of sleep, so I shouldn't be bitching.
I woke up at 1 in the morning and I went to work.
I should have said hi.
No, my 1 in the morning is not your 1 in the morning.
Yeah, that's... I try to get to sleep by like 10 or 11, and then I've been sleeping in for a while, so it's just... I'm tired.
I'm tired too.
We haven't got there yet,
but I will.
We can't burn the cardboard boxes, right?
Correct. We're stacking them. Oh,
okay, good, because I've been trying to fish these out of everywhere, and it's driving me nuts.
That sounded like a figure of speech for a second. I was going to say, is that like burning the midnight oil?
No.
Burning the cardboard boxes. That sounds like the redneck version of that.
Are we just going to forget about them at the moment? But like, I've done my best with the barrels. We don't even need to use half the space for them. But like, are we just going to leave the boxes wherever they are?
I noticed the barrels are stacked very well.
Have you guys ever heard of a game called The Forest?
I've heard of it, yes, but I don't know
Survival
what it's about.
Horror,
yes, there's someone who keeps insisting on us playing that, and we got to do a co-op of that sometime.
I feel that you would like it, and you can have 3 players in a game, so if you play that, I would love to join.
Someone needs to buy it for
I'm not sure what you'll think of my other company if you join with him, but if you two want to join a game with me sometime, I'd be fine with that, too.
Yes. I love The Forest.
I used to watch somebody who played it, but I forgot who it was.
The inventory screen breaks my mind, though, when
that's
full.
Yeah, it can be pretty crowded.
It's survival horror, though? I don't know good with horror.
Well, you have to fight cannibals, but it's mostly, like, setting up a base camp and keeping yourself, like, fed and watered and not eating poisonous berries, which I do anyway.
Yes, cast cannibals in quotes. Let's not tell him what he's in for there. Let's just keep him with that delusion.
Cannibibbles.
There's a med kit that needs to be in the display room.
So let's see what these Spartan phoenixes are like.
I have to go in about 15-20 minutes.
Be careful with the guns, Nick. Once you reload ammo in them.
No, I'm just putting them where they are for now, where they need to go.
Good, yeah. Once you put ammo in them, or once you hook them up and then put ammo in them, they will shoot you on sight if you're carrying something through a blue barrier.
God, you can't move when I'm like trying to turn it around and put it in an actual first-person mode and the game freezes up on you.
Yeah, it kind of does that.
Have I done all the guns?
Nope. You need to fill... Oh, you got that one with ammo. Good. You got that one.
I put ammo in all of them, I think.
Yeah, I see that one. There should be 6 guns. How many did you replace? There needs to be one right here.
I've only counted 3. Oh god, there's one in here that's all busted up still.
There's 2 in the display room that need to be replaced. I already
took
them down.
Oh god.
Uh-oh. Did you trigger one?
I didn't think that was gonna do it, but apparently I was wrong.
What did you do? Oh, Nick. Come on.
That and I also thought I had the fucking thing protecting me, but again, I was wrong.
Oh, hell. Did you die? All did right. it kill you?
There's one bullet hole, and how the hell
Two
am I gonna do
casings.
This?
Oh, no, there's many bullet casings. God damn it, Nick.
Oh, fuck.
Toss it through first.
Okay. I need physics for that.
No, no, it didn't work.
Well.
Oh, it's shooting at the thing you tossed. It's shooting at the thing you tossed. Wow.
We just had a whole day's work back, didn't we?
Just about. I told you
casings everywhere!
Yeah, you can thank good old Australian cat for that.
Y'all.
Like I said, y'all. I thought I had it covered. Well, there's no way we can fucking get this out of the room. That thing's just gonna shoot me the moment I walk through the door with anything.
Yeah, pretty much. That's how it works. You did it, Nick.
Wait, is it out of ammo?
No, they don't go out of ammo, I don't think.
They don't?
I don't think so. After you fill it up, maybe they do. I don't know. I didn't. The wiki didn't say that.
Hmm.
Well, nothing short of god moding or ghost moding or something. I see how we're gonna pull this off.
Well, use it.
We've still got one gun to get to in here.
Use that. Use the god mod or ghost mod or whatever.
That won't stop it shooting at me.
No. Well, you're right. Damn it.
Ghost mode. You feel ethereal. Okay.
You can't see things through walls, though.
No, but I was thinking. How the hell are we going to do this?
I don't know, Nick. You're the one that did it in the first place.
Rip.
I don't think they shoot you if you hold ammo, but they'd certainly shoot you if you hold a gun.
I know this isn't going to be a good idea. But I've given up at this point.
I'm scared.
Where's the laser gun?
Nick, just clock out. Replace these two guns in the display room. Let's help stack these crates. And then
I'm really bad at stacking crates. This pile was me. So
yeah,
I probably should not.
Modern art over there. Yeah. This pile's me though, so I'm not much better.
Okay,
I'm
good.
Not putting any ammo in that thing yet.
And then there's one on the other side, Nick, over here. I don't have it. Yeah, you need to print it out. You need a vend one, but it goes right here.
Oh, okay.
Why is Nick so good at stacking?
I don't know. I mean,
because I had a fucking super critical person blow my expectations away there, and I had to get him back. I had to prove myself. Hence, look, Daddy, look what I did, Daddy.
Yeah.
Oh right! Look you what don't... I did, Daddy.
Of course, you're gonna see it when I do the video. But there's one where it's just me and Nick, right?
Uh-huh.
And he's got on the flying cheat code, the jet boots, I like to call them. And I leave him in charge of stacking stuff, barrels and crates.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And I'm over there doing everything else. Well, kind of like
we're coming up on that one.
It's that we are coming up on it. It's part five, I believe. So he's in charge of stacking stuff, and I'm doing other stuff like throwing away trash and stuff. And all of a sudden, I come around the corner, and just to check up on his progress, and all the barrels are just piled on top of each other like a mountain, like your crates are. But it's barrels.
Yeah.
Whereas you're allowed to stack crates like that, you are not allowed to stack barrels like that. The game will penalize you for it.
Okay, where?
Really?
Where is the laser gun?
Oh, I don't know. But you're going to get shot at if you carry it through a barrier.
I'm not intending to carry it through the barrier. I want to test another theory. There it is, okay.
Yeah. So, you're supposed to stack barrels straight up, vertically. You're not supposed to be on their sides or any other way. And this mountain of barrels was like every other way you could possibly imagine. They were toppling over each other. It was, oh my god, it was a disaster. I turn around the corner and I see that and I'm like, Nick, what the actual shit? And from that point onward,
I figured it out.
From that point onward,
I figured out how we're gonna.
Until just recently, I said no, Nick, you're not allowed to do barrels. So yeah. Anyway, what?
You're not gonna like it, but I found a way to beat the guns.
Oh dear. How's that?
I reckon we should save this level and come back to it later.
Nick.
It worked. We can get it clean now.
But it took so long.
Where does blood come from? This is your blood, ain't it? They just,
It shouldn't be.
Holy shit, Nick. It still shot at you even if you didn't die.
I know, there was no avoiding that.
Nick.
Is there any sort of like invincibility console command?
There is, but it'll still shoot at you.
I reckon I could have beaten these things even without it. Speaking of.
Where are y'all?
In the main office.
I'm so sorry.
I'm cleaning up the soot since that was my main. The main downside of what I did.
Look at all this blood and soot and bullet casings. It's a disaster.
I'm on it. It was already a disaster.
It's a disaster.
Nick, when you're done mopping stuff, just clock out, please. End the level.
Fine, fine. We'll leave the bullet holes where they are.
Okay, because I need to go soon.
Throw away the shitty guns. Throw those away. But leave the casings, leave the bullet holes. Who cares? At worst, we'll get demoted. At best, we'll probably get promoted. There's no employee of the month here, though.
I don't think there ever was going to be, but we'll see.
There was, until you got shot to hell.
Also, I just realized if we get shot at by carrying things through the machine, why the heck aren't they shooting at us for carrying the brooms through?
Because they're in our inventory. They're, like, attached to us like the mop.
They want us to clean them.
It's only if we carry stuff with our hands.
My cat is in the window and I want to go squish her face.
Go, I'll take care of things here.
Nick, just fuck out.
Oh. You wanted the guns back, didn't you? Oh, all right.
Well, I just want to get rid of the shitty guns.
I wish I could do give me some paperwork. I'm going to have some fun. Best day ever? I'm afraid to sleep.
Yeah, you can change that.
I browned out.
You can change best day ever now.
Challenging, severe. No, that sounds pretty good. No, I'm afraid to sleep. Horrifying. Painful.
Challenging.
Let's go with painful.
Painful will work.
No, painful because it ended on pain.
Yeah, sure.
Work method. Please describe the method as a compelling job.
You can change that.
Well, it was wonderful until the guns were loaded.
Yeah.
We did it.
We got promoted.
Yay!
Wow. Good job,
Nicholas.
We did so good. You left the work site feeling confident that everything was in order. Oh, yes, we did. Everything's
We're
in
so
order.
Good. Woo! We're so good.
Oh.
We only died a couple times.
Hey, at least we don't have to worry about any guns this time, right?
I could fit those pants in here.
Why can't you be more like Minecraft?
No, don't say that.
Yeah. Alright, do it.
Look up last. I look up at the roof.